Hi, I'm Lise Colucci, one of the life coaches over at Queen Being. And on this show, we talk to narcissistic abuse survivors about topics, questions, or issues that they have in their own lives regarding being a narcissistic abuse survivor. If that sounds good, hit subscribe and let's go. We're talking to Ronnie today. Hi, Ronnie.
Hi, Lise.
How you doing?
Living the dream.
Living the dream. So what's going on with you?
Just in the middle of finalizing the divorce last Wednesday with my ex. Mm-hmm. And just trying to get through all the different things you don't know about when you're in a toxic relationship that kind of blindside you. So right now, just trying to, you know, kind of follow the rules of what you're supposed to do, which is hard. Right. And trying to understand how, I guess the biggest thing I've had with all this is being a guy. I mean, most of the stuff I see out there is about the guy being the abuser and the women being the abused. In my situation, you know, I'm a big guy. I'm a veteran. I've been through a lot of stuff, and I'm just amazed what a job was done to me emotionally. Mm-hmm. And how all the process to get through it and all the different terms that are actually used, and then to see how right they are, you know, from love bombing to discard to all of them. So it's kind of been a tough journey. It's been really, you know, kind of getting through it. And I think the biggest thing I got hung up on right now is the whole trauma bonding thing. Mm-hmm. That's been the worst one to get over right now, even after the divorce and even after being separated. And this is the fifth or sixth time she's left me in 13 years or 12 years. So,
well, let me ask you first on, there's two things. One is with having all the information out there be more geared toward the male being the abuser. What does that feel like as a survivor who is a man?
Bad. Yeah. It feels like, you know, I get on the support groups and stuff, but the whole thing is like, I'm one of the only few guys I see in there who want to say things, but you like, nobody gets it. So why would you want to say something? Because I feel like everybody on there is so hurt, you know? So it's been very hard because there's not really places guys go. I mean, if I go to my friends, they're all like, dude, you're a good looking guy. You got a great career. Just get over, you know? Or if I go anywhere, oh man, you know, we don't want to hear it, or, you know, so it's hard. So you just shut up about it. And nobody gets it. So by the time you explain to them Stockholm syndrome and trauma bonding and how they devalue you and all the love bombing and all the things, I mean, my case is a perfect textbook case. It's almost not worth explaining it to them. So you just withdraw. And then when you withdraw, you get in your head. And then you're like, well, what do I do? Nobody understands this. And then you try to be tough about it. So it gets rough.
Yeah, that makes sense. I'm wondering around that, like, what do you think would help men in this situation? I mean, more information.
I think we need to advocate for men to come out with their stories and tell them it's okay. You know, it's all right to be. I mean, no guy wants to be a dude that's been abused.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I was never given that it's okay to be weak. So by the time you realize you have this issue, maybe had I had it out earlier, mm-hmm. I could have saved myself a lot of this and my children a lot of this stuff.
So maybe it's realizing it's not weak, but vulnerable. Like, it's okay to be vulnerable. As a human being and not gender irrelevant. You know, that we're humans and we have emotions and we all have emotions. And that vulnerability is a strength, not a weakness. And
that's a good point right there. At least not to interrupt you, but, no, you know, again, in the guy's world, mm-hmm. okay, it's a weakness.
Right.
You go into the survivor world, you're a survivor, you're vulnerable. So the terminology even sometimes is hard to relate to because just our manhood is like vulnerable. I'll never be a victim or vulnerable, but I totally get it.
Sense. And what I'm hearing is that like a place for men to feel that their ability to be the man that they are is still intact while they go through something that is very vulnerable and very open.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. What do you think helped you the most, or what is helping you, or what, and what could be to create something where there is a safe place? I mean, I try to provide that as a coach, but
you guys, I will say this, you know, and whoever listens to this and as it gets out there, that finding Angie's channel was a blessing. Finding Span was a very big blessing. But you definitely get it. Like, you've been totally an advocate for understanding. I mean, you're the most comfortable of women that I feel like I'd be totally transparent with.
Okay.
So it's been good. I think right now we just have to really reach out to men through Span. and maybe for your channel, maybe.
What topics do you think are not covered? What, from your own personal experience, and like what questions you might have, or what you want to help others with understanding or feeling validated for? What, is there a topic in particular that you feel isn't maybe isn't the same or isn't covered in a way that also speaks to a more male survivor base?
Well, I think the biggest thing is letting them know they can reach out. They don't got to, they don't have to go to a bottle or to pills or to live in, you know, they could actually, the people out there exist. You know what I mean? Just knowing, I think that's a big thing. And then as far as the toxic subjects go, I mean, that's going to be up to the person, how much they want to investigate it. Cause there's information out there. The sex thing is very, the sex thing was a very tough one for me. Everything I read about it, was again looking from the female, the man being the manipulator or the control person and so forth. So as a guy, I had to go back and revisit that and go, wait a minute, you know, wow, we did have some issues there, but it wasn't so easy to see because she wasn't holding me down and beating me or nothing, but there was some stuff she would do that I found out later. And that was a real tough, cause it really messes you up, especially if you're an empath or you're an emotional guy. It's like, whoa, yeah, I do see where she controlled me. I mean, again, I think it's different. I think that it was a very tough subject to broach. Men, it's not a comfortable subject for men. I'm a respectable guy, so it's hard to talk about that with women. Sex was weird. I loved her so much, but it was so like her only. And then I think I even shared with you, oh, I'm done, get off. It was no, it was like, and who do you tell that to? I don't go to my buddies and say that. You know, you lie to your buddy and go, oh, man, it's freaking awesome. We're rocking the world. But I, where do you go with that? And I'm sure there's men out there that are suffering from that.
I think you're right. I think that is a really a big difference in how women approach being able to talk about it and how men approach being able to talk about it. Because a woman more than likely are able to say, this didn't feel right, this feel, this, I felt this about it. Like, they're able to express their feelings around sex with strangers a lot easier than the average man is. I mean, some men, and those men that can, they're great, they find their support, but for the men that feel like there's nowhere to go, or they don't have any sort of role models or peers that are going through the same thing, that can be a really, that can be a really great thing to explore with people. A narcissist uses sex for control. So there is a an side of it that is gender neutral. There is no gender bias, rather.
Right.
They use it for control. And so if you're with a narcissist, probably you are being controlled through sex. Usually they go to your vulnerability and use it as a weakness. Because your vulnerability is a strength, and that's the part, I think, for men in particular, and women also, a lot of women feel like they're so vulnerable, and they're so open in a relationship, and vulnerable, and then that's used, and therefore they see the vulnerability as a weakness. And I think men, me as well, but then the men have the aspect of societal training and the bias that creates in our heads of what it is to be a man. And the truth is, humans are vulnerable. Humans who have feelings and empathy, we're vulnerable, and it's a strength. Without the vulnerability, we can't connect. And the ability to connect, even in this conversation, that is a huge strength. It's what creates a life inside of us and outside of us that matches and is authentic. And so I think that the seeing that they use our vulnerability, which is a strength, and see it as a weakness, and they see it as a place to attack. But it's also, I think, a place they want to use because it's super powerful, because they don't have it, right?
Right, right. But I think, too, with that male-female aspect that we're self-wired with just from God, it makes it weird because men feel like they may be a failure in that department when they're not.
Right.
And but I feel like it's more of the emotional side that was attacked on me. So it was that emotional she used, you know, oh, I'm just another piece of meat to you. So I back off. Oh, I'm not good enough for you. Right. So you're like, what do I do? What do I do?
Because men can't talk about it or feel they can't talk about it. They feel that, and they don't really have an outlet that is acceptable, both in a society level and on a personal level for a lot of men.
Right. It's just a nightmare out there for us two, and I mean, like I said, thank God for you and finding the support group and all that. Cause I don't know how I would have done it. I really don't know how I would have done it. No, talk about it, guys. It's not something to be, I mean, it's a whole nother thing, you know? Mm-hmm. It's kind of like, it's a real deal. It's very real. And you got to get help for it. You have to get help, or have, not get help, but have somewhere to go to be told, yeah, man, I know what you're going through right now. That's called a discard. Oh, you know what she's going to do? She's going to do this next. Watch, you'll get a Hoover text tomorrow at 10.
Right.
Oh, now it's, you're starting to see them more as a fake person because they're following that manuscript so perfect that emotional people don't follow because we act on our emotions.
Right.
I can't tell you right now if I'm going to cry in an hour or not. I'm an emotional person. I have empathy. But I can guarantee that Narc's not going to cry in an hour. They might be thinking how they're going to get supply from you, get their bill paid, get their car fixed, get a booty call, but they're not going to think. And that's a big difference, I think.
Absolutely. I think that's great. I think that is that's a really good point to end with here. And I really appreciate your input because the male perspective is equally important to the female perspective in this. And it's really good to talk about it and get you guys some support and some community based around it. And I'm hoping that this shed some light for some people and shine some light. I'm hoping that this shines some light for some people and that it can provide some support just watching this video. And I'm also hoping that if anyone is interested in talking, that they will go to the links below and look me up. We can do something like this, or if you're interested in coaching, group coaching, or SPAN, you can look there too.
And be sure that coaching with you too, the group's good, but that stuff we did, the one-on-one is tremendous. Like, I mean, that night you really helped put a lot of things in perspective, because one thing I want to just say, because I know I talk a lot, is
I want to thank Ronnie for talking to me today. I'll have Ronnie on again on a later show to talk about more issues that pertain to being a male narcissistic abuse survivor. Again, I'm Lise Colucci, and I'm one of the life coaches over at Queen Being. Forget to hit subscribe. And for info about coaching, group coaching, or to be a guest on the show, please see the links below. Bye-bye.